Now if I just touch on our IPP programs, and again I'm stressing it's within the borders of South Africa, we have contracted a total of 6,300 megawatts with private sector generation. 98 megawatts coming from the WEPS environment, which is our wholesale electricity pricing. That is customers like the paper industry that from time to time export onto the grid and do not consume their own generation. We have a standard tariff that we do offer, and that falls under the WEPS. The MTPP, the 6 PPAs, that is the medium-term power purchasing program, a program Eskom ran about 6 or 7 years ago to procure energy from the industrial consumers, and we've contracted 417 megawatts on that. The STPP, which is short-term purchases that we've done over the last 3 years, and we've got 8 power purchase agreements giving us 231 megawatts there. The Munich Gens, the municipalities do have some old coal-fired power stations in their fleet that haven't been run and haven't been dispatched, and we obviously come on board to ensure that those plants are running. The one being in Kelvin Power Station, just outside the OR Tambo Airport, and then we certainly have 2 municipal generators in Pretoria, Tswane, Royal and Pretoria West. The DOE PECAS, which is a procurement program run by Department of Energy, and ultimately landed us signing the power purchase agreement last year with the GDF Sewers. A total of 1,005 megawatts was contracted there. Renewable bid window 1, 28 PPAs were concluded, 1,416 megawatts. Pleased to say about 20 of those are already connected to the grid as we speak. Bid window 2, 19 PPAs, 1,000 megawatts, 1,044 megawatts there. Bid window 3, November last year, 17 preferred bidders announced, giving us a further 1,456 megawatts. The small, and the small is between 1 megawatt and 5 megawatts. We ran a, Department of Energy ran a pre-qualification process, and a lot of those that have been pre-qualified were informed within the last 2 weeks, and we're now going to migrate into bid preparation for those pre-qualified for the small renewable. If we just look at the outcomes of the renewable bid window 1, 2, and 3, you can see round 1 wasn't competitive in terms of price. Wind came in at about 114 cents a kilowatt hour. We had a cap on the procurement process of 115. But the procurement process had what I call a two envelope system. The first envelope was pre-qualification, and the second envelope in terms of the evaluation criteria was 70% on price, 30% on economics. Due to very few projects passing the first envelope system, a lot of the bidders knew that once they go into the second envelope system, and at that stage we had the full 3,725 megawatts available, a lot of the bidders knew that if we bid at the cap, we almost guaranteed a PPA. So the prices were very close to the cap in round 1. Round 2, you could see they came down to 90 cents for wind, and round 3, the prices came down substantially at the lowest price, around about 65, 66 cents per kilowatt hour for wind. The concern on this slide I have is obviously the success rate. Through round 3, we had 93 bids come in, and only 18% were successful. So there's a phenomenal amount of very good bids out there, very good sites out there, developers that have spent excessive money in terms of preparing their bids and preparing themselves to meet the qualifying criteria, but just not sufficient capacity available. Department of Energy were looking at one stage to increase the megawatts allocated under bid window 3, and that process is still ongoing. In the later slides, I will touch on the challenges that we're facing in terms of bringing on more renewable capacity. The status of the IPP programs, MTPP 338 megawatts, all delivering power with the exception of one of the contracts that we signed with a company, Bloemfontein, that was doing the Bloemfontein municipal generation, did not reach commercial operation date. STPPs, the contracts terminated end of December. We managed to get them renewed in February this year, and they will at this stage expire on the 31st of May this year. The Munich generators, again similar to the STPPs, contracted from February, contracts expiring 31st of May 2014. Bid window 1 and 2, a total of 2,300 odd megawatts. 20 projects have already been connected to the grid. 8 projects are delivering energy in terms of early operating period as defined in the PPA. Five projects have further given us notice for early operating periods that they're coming online any. This slide is obviously with effect from February, at the end of February 2014, and in the last 14 days we have seen a few more guys connect to the grid. Three projects have achieved commercial operation date at the end of February, and we're expecting another 2 to 3 coming online this month. If we just continue, the WEPS is an ongoing procurement. It's around about 80 megawatts that we get from time to time from the WEPS customers. The Peakers is under construction. The DESA is due to come online 30th of August 2015. It's about a 300, just under 300 megawatts. That's in Kuha, Port Elizabeth. Automotive diesel peaking generation, similar to the Eskom fleet. The Avon is in Durban, and COD planned for 25th of March 2016. There is a little bit of risk on this date because not all building permits have been obtained for the Avon site. Bid window 3,456 megawatts, November 17th preferred bidders announced. We expect financial close, and we want to stagger financial close probably before the end of July 2014 this year. We'll have financial close on those 17 bidders. The small renewable, we're now migrating into the phase where the bidders need to prepare their bid submission.